Hi, this is Jenlo with Jenlo Designs, and this is the seventh night of lights. Tonight I'm going to be working with opals in ice cube trays. And I want to show you this to start out with. This has got quite a bit of depth, a dimension to it, but you can do this as thick or thin as you want. So first I wanted to explain about silicone ice cube trays. They come, and they're very, very flexible like this. Now, I think they make, some of these are cupcake tins, some are baking tins. You can find them at a specialty food cooking store, or you can get them in the cake decorating section of your local craft store. So these are just a few of the ones that I have kept whole. You can see they come with a couple of different designs per tray. But then my friends and I, we cut them up and we do swaps. So we have squares, and is that cute? That's a palm tree. Yeah, that's an ice cube tray. This one is a watermelon slice. You can see the detail in there. This is a pineapple. And here we have a star. And last week I was in the store, and lo and behold, I came up with a tray of snowflakes, and I've already cut them up and started trading them with my friends here locally. So we're going to use these tonight. I'll be back in a minute, and we'll get started. Okay, for this first sample, I've taken frozen opals, which come in a package that looks like this, and I've just broken them up, and I've set them down into the very bottom of the pan here, and I'm going to put this over on my melting pot and let those melt from the bottom up. If I don't have anything, you know, in the bottom like that, I can just put down the opals. This is just plain Franklin opals, not mixed with anything that I poured in here. And I'm going to put that in the melting pot and let that melt from the bottom up as well. In my other melting pot, I've already poured in some opals, and as you can see, they're starting to melt. So as soon as all that gets melted, we'll come back and go from there. Okay, one of the simplest processes is to take the melted opals that are in the melting pot and just pour them into the mold. And then I'm taking bits and pieces of our fantasy film that we had left over from this week, and I'm just going to lay those down in on top of that. I'm using tweezers because I don't want to touch it. It's still very, very hot. It hasn't started to cool off yet in there, but I'm just putting these down randomly. Try and spread those out a little bit in there. I'm going to take some more opals that I've already melted and pour those in on top. And what we're doing is we're encasing the fantasy film between layers of opals. But you could also encase like a little peel off or a sticker or just anything you wanted to put in there. Doesn't matter. You just simply pour in a layer, put in your second ingredient, and pour another layer on top to seal that. Okay, so that's one way to do this. And when you're done, then you're going to get something that looks like this. You can see the reflection of the opals that are embedded inside of my snowflake. The top, which is actually the bottom of the mold, the part that hits the air, is going to be shiny. The part that's down in the mold is going to be sort of a matte finish to it. So on this one, I don't know if you can see from the side here, I colored my bottom layer with blue opals, and then went in and put my fantasy film, and on top of that, I put clear opals. The possibilities on this are just endless. Okay, the opals that I put down in here, the frozen opals, have melted now, so I've taken that out of my melting pot. And once again, I'm just going to spoon in a thin layer of melted opals over that. And when that's done, that was what I did to make the opalized snowflake, clear snowflake, for the top of this little sample card. I wanted to show you a couple more samples. If you put just straight stars in the bottom, and then I put in quite a thick layer of opals mixed with blue, the stars will melt up into the opals, but they will stay on the very top and they don't flick off. So it gives it a very textured look, like you put glitter on the top, but this is just a fun way to do it. This is another one where I did clear in my snowflake, just clear opals, Franklin opals, and then when it was done, I took it out and I finger painted stickles, glitter, turquoise glitter on top of that, and then just wiped it off so that the glitter embedded down into the design on there. And this is see-through, so any color paper that you put behind that, you're going to be able to see through that. And I just happen to have a piece of Aurora here in the fantasy film, so you can see how you can put that back there and you can still see a little bit of shadows through that, but it'll give a bit of a reflection there. So another fun little thing you can do. And then finally, you can simply take a silver, well, any color, but I used a silver Krylon pen here, and I just started painting the edges of this and painting the embossed ridges on the top. So you can see how much it made that one pop. This one, I don't know if you can see, I also see little dots down in the center there. Those are little cheap plastic rhinestones that I just dropped down into the opals as it was, when it was hot and all melted. So it kind of gives it the look of snowflakes within a snowflake. So many of my students ask me how to clean a melting pot, so I'm going to show you that next as a little bonus tip here tonight. I simply take whatever's left in here and take my spatula and just let it come out onto the craft sheet. When that dries on the craft sheet, I'm pull it off and just stick it down in a Ziploc baggie because I can come back later and throw that in. So I'm going to get my melting pot as clean as I can this way. And just see my spatula laying there because that'll come up too. And then I'm going to take some paper towels and I'm going to roll them up. And I'm just simply going to wipe this out and then take and put that hot in the middle so I don't burn my fingers with it. I get about two wipes, put that on your craft sheet, pull off just another roll of paper towels, fold them up, and wipe out the tip, and wipe off the end, and there, my melting pot is just as clean as if it were brand new. Okay, I've taken these out of the molds now. This is the clear with the fantasy film inside of it, and you can compare that now to the blue that I did previous. You could do pink, green, you know, any color of opals you want with the fantasy film stuck down in it. You could change the color of the fantasy film to get different looks as well. Okay, this is the one with the frozen opals down in it. That's the top, and this is the back. And I just want to kind of show you how this is reflective of different colors that you can put behind it. So there it is with blue. And then if I bring this purple up, you can see how it just kind of picks up and reflects the color behind it. I'm getting a little bit more of the pinks in this one here. So once again, you can just play with that as much as you like. So here we are. This is the seventh night of lights, and I hope you'll check back again tomorrow night for our final night. You can find more information on my blog at jen-low-designs.blogspot.com. Thanks.